Hi and welcome to a let's play of the new Cold War mod for Hearts of Iron 3, which is my own mod that I have made, and I will play as Russia and with their head of state Makary Sokolov, and we'll take the country beyond the furthest borders of the Russian Empire. So, yeah. Let's beat the crap out of the Europeans. Here we go. Yeah, so let's take an initial look. First off, Eastern Russia. Ignore that. Is not part of the mod, just the Western European part, as well as Abkhazia and South Ossetia, or whatever they are called. And yeah, the mod is set in 2030, so in 2022 Russia invaded Ukraine, took the middle and eastern part of the country, made the western part a puppet state, which is yeah, even more brutal and authoritarian than Russia itself. It's basically the North Korea of Europe, while at the same time it's a puppet state of another major power. Poland is split into two in a civil war between European-backed government in the west and the nationalist rebel Poland in the east, which is backed by Russia. You might wonder, why would Russia and Poles cooperate with each other? They hate each other, and yeah, probably, but well, nationalism and beating the crap out of the pro-Europeans was apparently enough to make them cooperate with each other. And yeah, Belarus joined Russia as well. They didn't want the same thing happen to them as with Ukraine, so they joined voluntarily shortly after. And then the big blue thing. What the hell is that? That is the European Federation. When the EU, the European Union, turns into a federal state. Yeah, it's a corrupt, bureaucratic, thinks of itself as the good guy, but often, or at least sometimes, goes too far and does bad things. So, yeah. Russia, the imperialists, they are in this mod, aren't exactly the saviors of Europe either, so none of the major powers are the good guys, really. Then you got the Union of Norway, which stayed out of the EU and the EF after that, and the reason why they are a union is because they're in a union with Iceland, which also stayed out of the EU. And yeah, everyone's heard of the Brexit, I guess. England and Wales, or at least the entire Great Britain and United Kingdom, left the EU, but Scotland and Northern Ireland shortly rejoined it. Also Gibraltar joined the EU as well. It wasn't feasible to stay out of the EU anymore for Gibraltar. And Greece was kicked out of the EU for obvious economic reasons. The Middle East finally sorted itself out. No more Islamist guy in Kurdistan. Free, liberal, secular Turkey. Yeah, it's basically a Western liberal democrat's fantasy of what everything should be if everything goes great. Yeah. It's just a fantasy, but There's enough shit in that region, so let's have things go good for once. And the Libyan Federation, basically all borders are unchanged in here. There's EF, European Federation troops, in Tunisia and Egypt, which are their allies. Yeah, that's basically the introduction. Let's put some music on. I have it turn off when I'm making time lapses. Also, the master volume was off. I don't hear any music right now, but yeah. So, let's look at our politics. We are a pro-Russian dictatorship. Surprise, surprise. Nobody could have expected that. The government is, of course, pro-Russian. The political system has been remade in the mod, so you currently only have three proper ideologies or parties. You got pro-Russian, neutral, and pro-European. This really represents several parties holding that view. And all the European countries, major and minor, all have their entire ministers filled out, but the Middle Eastern and North African ones only have their head of state and head of government filled out, since there were so many of them. And laws have also been somewhat redone. So we're currently authoritarian, which, yeah, well, you can see the bonuses and the cons you get out of that. We also currently have a wartime draft. We are pro-Russian in our international stance. Surprise, surprise. We maybe should be changing this. Yeah, I'm thinking maybe mixed industry. And how the hell does Russia have free press? Maybe that should be fixed. Well, we're changing to state press right now, just because we can. Our focus, well, we can't actually change it, but you will see why soon. So, let's draw up some, or first let's automate trade. Then we should draw up some theaters. We got a starting army of 522,000 troops. Let's see. We got one theater covering an entire country. But let's make the second army into another theater. Like that. There's only 66,000 troops over there. Maybe we should get more, but let's automate both of them. And we also need a cutoff theater as well, which we will tell the AI to not be garrisoning, so we don't waste resources going there. That should be fine. Also automate the European one like that. Yeah, we should the first thing we should do is make intelligence. National unity is fine, but can be improved even further. You see the pro-Russian stance is currently increasing our national unity already, but this can and should be increased even further. Let's do technology. Officers are, well, we can do a little at least. Like two, perhaps. We don't need diplomacy. We don't need much espionage either. We can lower it even more, like to 30. And the rest goes into research, which, well, we need to improve our infantry. I think I should increase the sound. Well, it's more louder for me. I'm still not hearing any music. We don't have any tanks at all. Well, we should get tanks. There's at least 2-4 medium tanks, so yeah, you can double click them. I don't remember that. I don't want any fleet or aircraft that can just be ignored. Well, this is far in the future, it's like 7 years in the future, so no. All of these are almost at least 3 years. Well, industrial production seems good. Only 125 days. Yeah. Yeah, that's very good. Let me take those. And then some land doctrines as well. Well, we got 2 research left. Yeah, that's probably good. Yeah, let's take those. And yeah, then we're done with that. We should set up some production. Let's do some upgrades. We don't need any reinforcements right now. Consumer goods, we need a hell of a lot of. And yeah, then we have leftover for production. So let's create some infantry armies. And a whole lot of them as well. We have enormous amount of manpower currently. Yeah, let's make like 30. Let's start the clock for now. Yep, that happened. So we can only produce a third of these, but then we have some backup ones we can make those. Let's put this a little above than what it really needs, so it doesn't bother us. Yeah, let's click these away. Then we have first we have the introduction, which there is for, well, most of the countries. So here you can read the backstory in case you want to know that for the motherland. And back to the game, production focus selection. So as I showed you earlier, there's a production focus in which you can increase the build speed for certain units, but you can't pick them manually. You have to do that through an event. And once you have picked a focus in order to get the event again, you just pick the no focus one, and then you will get the event again, so you can pick a new focus. And currently we're only producing infantry, so I'm picking that one. Yep, that's good. And yeah, I believe I will cut the video here and adjust the message settings, which is a feature, a lovely feature, which is not in HOI 4. Why? I don't know. It really should be in there. Well, here it is in all its glory. All the pop-ups and messages can be customized, and it's lovely. Completely wonderful. Yep, see you in the next video. I will be adjusting this so it is playable and I get notices when everything important happens, so that we can make the best of this game. Thanks for watching.